The greatest thing about attitude is that we are always in control of our own. And there's a lot of people that either don't want to get that or don't understand that. And they choose to have a negative attitude. An attitude in many ways defines the culture of your program. And the culture of our program has continued to grow, especially since Christmas, okay? But the guy that has the best attitude, bar none, any coach, any player, Joe Cotter. Come here, Joe. Joe's attitude is an example of how every one of us needs to be every day. Every day. He brings positive energy. He cares about others. He's all about doing for others. And we appreciate all the help that you bring to us.
Yes, sir.
Break us down?
What?
You want to break us down?
Yes, sir.
First time I met Joe, freshman year, coming in for basketball camp. I'm sitting there waiting to, saw this kid out here shooting basketball, making everything he's shooting. I'm like, all right, well, this is going to be a pretty good freshman coming in with us. Find out he's going to be the manager of the team. So that was really the first time I met him, basketball camp, freshman year. Oh, I've never seen Joe upset except for after we lose a game. And even then, he's always looking at the bright side of things. I know that you can never be in a bad mood around Joe because he's always bringing the best out of everybody. Biggest thing with Joe, just keep staying the same way he is. If he keeps that same attitude, he's always working hard, working out all the time, always got high energy and always in a great mood. If he keeps that attitude, he's going to succeed very well in life.
I met Joe at an off-campus party my sophomore year when he was technically a freshman, because it was with the basketball boys, and since he is so close with the basketball team, he happened to be there. And when I met him, he was one of the happiest people at this party, and I was like, what a fun kid. And him and I were pretty friendly over the course of the next few years, and then Coach Paige Moyer asked if I would like to help tutor him, and I was like, absolutely. I didn't have to think twice about it because I eat lunch with him anyways. I see him all the time anyways. I don't know. What am I not going to miss about Joe? He is just so inviting. If he even sees just you out of the corner of his eye, he is, hey, how are you? Hi, how are you? I'm just going to miss someone as positive and happy as him being around all the time.
I can't express what it feels like to go into a room and he just, I mean, Jen said this before, but he lights up the room. Everyone can feel his presence and all the positivity that surrounds him and his beautiful soul.
I went for a run with him once, and that was the last time because he was too fast for me and I was dying after the run, so.
Joe's the most caring and charming individual you'll ever meet and that I've met within my 4 years at Roanoke, and I've just, you know, he's someone that brightens your day even if I'm in a bad mood or, you know, not really wanting to tutor that day or something. Like, he always just makes it so worthwhile and just is such a bright spirit that is contagious really at the end of the day.
Joe's also the most popular person in Salem or Roanoke. Every time that I hang out with him outside of school, it's like we can't walk five steps without someone knowing him or his family. He's really got a place here in this community, and that's wonderful to see. Since I've been tutoring Joe, I've noticed that he's had a lot of trouble with run-on sentences and past tense, and both of these things kind of come up every time he does a writing assignment. So we've really been nailing those down, and now Joe doesn't always get it the first time, but what I see is that when I say, Joe, is there anything wrong with a sentence, he'll look at it, he'll say, okay, I bet it's a run-on sentence, or he'll say, oh, that should have had an ED on the end, and so He's not all the way there yet, but he's getting so much closer, and I think we're going to really make some breakthroughs by the end of the year in his writing.